church in cities. Father, in the mighty name of Jesus, you have given us the blessing of being alive today. Lord, you have given us the gift of life this morning. And we thank you very much,
Jehovah.
In the mighty name of Jesus. Because there are many people who have not woken up today. And yet for us, you gave us the gift of life. Father, may you help us to glorify you with our lives today. Father, you have also given us the gift of salvation. May your authority prevail over our lives. And Lord, you have brought me to this nation of Finland. I ask you to open their spiritual ears, that they may get to hear you.
Että he kuulisivat sinua.
Open their spiritual eyes.
Avaa heidän hengelliset silmänsä.
That they may get to see this dispensation.
Että he tulevat näkemään tämän tilanteen.
And experience the visitation of the Lord.
Ja sen Herran kohtaamisen kokemuksen.
That they may get to prepare the glorious way.
Että he valmistautuvat kirkkaalla tavalla.
For the glorious coming of the Messiah.
Herran kirkkaaseen tulemukseen.
The nation of Finland.
Suomen kanssa.
That she may also assemble before the Lord.
Että se tulee Herran eteen.
On that mighty day of reckoning.
Siinä mahtavassa tunnustuksessa.
In the mighty, mighty, mighty name of Jesus.
Mahtavassa, mahtavassa nimessä.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Thank you so much. I bless you very much in the name of the Lord. I see many people, I see that so many are here. Thank you very much for coming all the way from Jyväskylä, Owuor.
Welcome
also from Jyväskylä.
Thank you very much.
The Lord bless you. So can we be seated in the mighty presence of the Lord? Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
I want to recognize also the presence of many people from other nations of Europe. Thank you so much. Where are you? The translator. Oh, thank you so much. Good to see you, my son. Thank you very much. Thank you, I can see you. I want to also recognize the people from other nations of Europe. And I know you are here from Denmark. Where are my daughters from Denmark? With the babies, where are you? Okay, so all you are worshipping, you change your clothes, right? Thank you so much. And I see Pastor Charles from Italy is here. Thank you so much for coming. And my son Daniel is the name, right?
Yeah.
Thank you so much. The Lord bless you abundantly. And Sweden, Netherlands. We are. Thank you so much. Pastor Banta is here from Amsterdam. You came with somebody, right?
Yes, I know somebody.
Yes, Amsterdam also?
No, he's living here.
Oh, you stay here, thank you very much. And any other countries of Europe? So, everybody, try to get a seat, even the protocol people at the gate, get a seat and a book and a pen. Even the protocol people just sit and write down these things. Austria is there, my daughter there, Austria. I don't mean Ireland. Where is your mom? She's not here. She's around also, right? The name? Okay, thank you so much, my daughter. There are quite a lot of people from Europe.
Estonia,
thank you very much. Are we going to come to Estonia? Are you going to receive me there? Because you will have to talk to Pastor Anna until I is here. She's suffering. Yes, you will have to talk to her. Yes, so that we can develop a roadmap.
The word said that they have shown it.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Thank you for coming to translate today. Because yesterday was very good. But as we move now closer to the healing service tomorrow, I want to thank all the pastors who have been involved in organizing this meeting. Thank you very much for putting this together, the logistics. And all the people behind the scenes. Thank you. Now, yesterday, we already began to talk about the mighty visitation of the glory of the Lord. And what came out very clearly is that we are a blessed generation. The generation that needs to see to see the glory of God. And so that is something you cannot take away from this generation. Because if you read the Bible, you will find that the apostles and the prophets of the Bible, when they saw these visions of what would happen in these days, some of them, their hearts were crushed. And they cried out to the Lord. And they said, Lord, who are those people? Which generation is that that will get to see your glorious visitation, as we are going to see very, very shortly right now? The reason they were coveting, they were admiring this generation, is because they saw that the visitation of the latter glory would come with certain benefits.
Tuo erityisiä hyötyjä.
Certain benefits like power.
Erityisiä etuja, kuten voima.
Certain benefits like power to overcome sin.
Kuten voima voittaa synnin.
Power to bring deliverance and healing.
Voima tuoda vapautta ja parantumista.
Power to elevate the church.
Voima kohottaa seurakunta.
Resuscitate the church.
Ja suojella seurakunta.
Restore the church.
Uudistaa seurakunta.
Exalt the church.
Kohottaa seurakunta.
Glorify the church.
Kirkastaa seurakunta.
The image of the church.
Ja antaa seurakunnan kuva.
The reputation of the church.
Seurakunnan suositus.
And as we are going to see very briefly, some of them had even seen the dispensation of closed heaven. When heaven is closed and there is no rain, and then all of a sudden they see now the open heaven, then it shocked them. Because they saw that there was a desperation for a visitation. There was a longing and desire, Lord, visit us. And then when the Lord visits, then they saw the remission and the restoration. And so these are things that meant the other generation.
Ja nämä ovat asioita, jotka tulevat sillä myöhäisemmällä sukupolvella.
Long to live to see this hour.
Kauan on odotettu tätä hetkeä.
That's why I'm saying what came out very clearly yesterday.
Ja sen tähden haluan vielä sanoa sen, mitä tuli selväksi eilen.
Is that we must be a blessed generation.
Että meidän täytyy olla siunattu sukupolvi.
So that we can live to see this.
Että saamme elää nähdäksemme tämän.
Which was talked about in the Bible.
Mistä Raamattu on puhunut.
And it was assigned a duty, a task. And so this is what we're going to look at today. What is the role of the visitation of the Lord at this hour?
Mikä sen merkitys on, että Herra kohtaa tällä tänään?
And so yesterday,
ja eilen,
I spoke a little bit
puhuin hieman
on the message that the Lord Jehovah the Father is speaking to the church now that he has come into the church.
Siitä, että hän tulee kohtaamaan seurakunnan.
And I spoke about the preparation for the midnight hour.
Ja puhuin keskiyön hetken valmistautumisesta.
And what came out very clearly.
Ja tuli hyvin selväksi.
Without confusion, that stood out very sharp yesterday.
Se oli hyvin ilman epäselvyyttä ja oli selvää eilen.
Is that God the Father?
Että Isä Jumala
has come to redirect the church.
Ja on tullut antamaan suuntaa seurakunnalle.
Back to the blood and the cross.
Takaisin veren evankeliumin ja ristiin.
Because he said yesterday.
Koska eilen tuli esille.
The blood.
Veri.
The blood.
Veri.
The blood of Jesus.
Jeesuksen veri.
Is still saving souls.
Vielä voittaa sielu.
And still has enough power.
Ja sillä vielä on se voima.
To deliver men from sin.
Vapauttaa synnistä.
So it's amazing.
Joten se on hämmästyttävää.
That even when the latter visitation of this hour arrives.
Että jopa silloin kun tämä myöhempi vierailu tapahtuu.
He still points at the sacrifice of the cross.
Hän kohdistaa huomion ristin uhriin.
In other words, he has come to re-establish the statutes of God.
Ja hän on tullut ennalleen asettamaan.
Yes, the statutes, the laws of the blood.
Tämän veren lait.
And so that was the beautiful message we saw yesterday.
Ja tämä oli ihana sanoma.
And today is going to be a final session.
Ja tänään tulee viimeinen jakso.
And I think we have two sessions today.
Ja meillä on kaksi jaksoa tänään.
And then after that tomorrow we'll slowly transition into the healing service.
Ja huomenna sitten menemme siihen parantumispalveluksiin.
And I say also.
Ja minäkin sanon.
That these are the days when the Lord is visiting the nation. And so, for those that will heed God, He will visit you. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And it also came out very clearly yesterday in the message. That when we read from the scripture in the book of Exodus 12,
ja kun luimme toisen Mooseksen kirjan 12 lukua,
when he said,
jossa hän sanoi,
that if the household is too small for a whole lamb,
että jos kotitalous on liian pieni syödäkseen koko lammasta,
if the family,
jos perhe,
it's too small, if it's too small for a whole lamb,
on liian pieni syömään koko lammasta,
he said, share the lamb.
Niin se tulisi jakaa toisen perheen kanssa.
And I said,
ja sanoin,
that is yet another testimony.
Ja se on toinen todistus.
That the Lord was saying.
Että Herra sanoi.
That the lamb of sacrifice at Calvary.
Että uhrilammas Golgata.
The Passover lamb of God.
Pääsiäis, Herran pääsiäislammas.
Was more than sufficient.
Oli enemmän kuin tarpeeksi.
To save all men.
Pelastamaan kaikki ihmiset.
Because in Egypt,
koska Egyptissä,
when this cloud visited,
missä tämä pilvi vieraili,
I mean when Israel was in Egypt,
ja silloin kun Israel oli Egyptissä,
and was being delivered,
ja vapautettiin sieltä,
and this cloud visited Moses,
ja tämä pilvi tuli kohtaamaan Moosesta,
he spoke these things,
puhui nämä asiat,
he said, the midnight hour.
Että keskiyön hetki.
And he said, that is the hour for deliverance, the hour for salvation.
Se on vapautumisia meidän pelastuksemme hetki.
For now, our deliverance is nearer than when we first believed.
Meidän vapautuminen on lähempänä kuin silloin, kun uskoon tuli.
And he talked about preparedness, how to prepare for the midnight hour. And he saw some of the laws of the blood we talked about, the blood. And those of you who fear the law, it's the grace of the blood. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And so, if you fear the law of the Old Testament, then I come now. To tell you that the new law of the grace is a higher law. So we love the law. The law of the Lord. Very good. So I want to begin today. And again, I say, this is on the website. I don't know whether it's in, I think there are many languages on the website, right? I'm just going to read through very briefly, then I'll describe it. It's a prophecy alert that I gave on May 4th, 2014. And I'm reading this now. And it says, on May 14th night, the Lord spoke with me in a very tremendous and unusual way, in which I saw the mighty vision of God regarding events about to happen. In that vision, the Lord all of a sudden took me to a place at which he asked me to look up into the sky. Can I describe it now? And what happened is this: the Lord took me to a place. And at that place, the voice spoke from heaven and asked me to look up into the sky. And then at first I did not understand when I looked up. Because I thought I was looking at the sun. I could not look at the sun. I could not look at the glory, the light. Because when I looked up, it was so bright. And the rays were coming from there like this to the ends of the earth, to the horizons of the earth. And so, from where I was standing, this is a tremendous glory. I thought it was the sun. The sun. Yes. And then the glory was going from there all the way like a dome to the ends of the horizon, to the ends of the horizon, to the end. So I was like standing inside a dome of rays. So that was tremendous to me. So I could not look. It was so bright. I thought it's the sun. But what amazed me, the rays, in this write-up, you hear me talk about the patterns of the rays. It came from one place, going this way, going that way, like a dome, coming from one center. And then all of a sudden, the Lord asked me to look in all my, toward my left, which is in the direction facing east. And so I remember when I turned toward my left, it was more like it's going to be a little bit of evening. And so when I looked towards the direction facing left, my left, in that mighty conversation, then it's like, you know, the rays were going to the ends of the horizon, the ends of the horizon of the earth.
maan ääriin asti.
And so when I looked what's left in that conversation, then I want to describe this. Some of you maybe have, I think you're near the ocean here, right? So sometimes when you're near the ocean, even on the land though, even on the land, but it's more pronounced when you're near the ocean, or a sea, or a lake.
Se on vähän erilaista, jos on merta ja järveä ja vettä.
And so, when I look towards the ends of the horizon,
ja kun katsoin sinne aivan loppuun asti, minne se ulottuu.
Then I saw as if there is going to be a rainstorm on the other side of the other, maybe a lake or something, but the other side, there's going to be rainstorm, a storm.
Näin, että myrsky, tuo sadetta oli menossa ylitse.
Why?
Miksi?
Because indeed, you know the way sometimes there's going to be a storm there, it's going to in the evening. Hallelujah. In the evening on the other side, sometimes when there is going to be a rainstorm there, it doesn't kick lightning on the other side.
Illalla siellä on ukkosen jyrinää ja salamoita.
So I saw twice kick like that side.
Näin niitä salamoita.
And then he said, look, the Messiah is coming.
Ja hän sanoi, katso, Messias on tuossa.
And then the Lord came.
Ja sitten Herra tuli.
And he took the church.
Ja otti seurakunnan.
But the event that happened after that
Se tapahtui sen jälkeen.
Is what I want to share with you a little bit on this.
Ja siksi hieman jauhan tästä.
Because they said, look, the Messiah is coming.
Katso, Messias on tulossa.
But look at this now.
Mutta entä nyt?
In my heart,
minun sydämessäni,
he made me know that look, the Messiah is coming.
Messias on tulossa.
But the church, listen the way he put it in my hand, the church out there is not ready.
Mutta seurakunta, joka siellä on, se ei ole valmis vielä.
So it is better.
Joten salamoita tulee.
Then he took the church.
Jotta hän voi ottaa seuraa.
Like lightning, when there is going to be a storm that's like twice. Like many times it lights up that sky, right?
Sieltä tuli salamointia kaksi kerralla.
And so then he took the church.
Hän otti seuraa.
But what happened after that?
Mutta mitä sen jälkeen tapahtui?
I found myself on the soil.
Näin itseäni maan kamaralla.
And I began to roll in that vision. I was rolling like this.
Aloin möyriä sitä.
Rolling the soil.
Pyörittää maata.
And as I was rolling,
silloin se maa pyöri siinä.
I was crushing my teeth.
Se murskasi minun hampaitani.
And I was wailing and weeping very
loud. Itken ja valitin.
I was wailing and crushing my teeth.
Valitin ja kiristelin hampaitani.
And rolling on the soil.
Ja pyörin maassa.
And then I woke up, right?
Ja sitten nousin ylös.
And then I woke up.
Heräsin.
And then after that, that's the day I gave this prophecy aloud. I posted on the web.
Ja minä kirjoitin tämän profetin.
And I said, the Messiah is coming.
Joka osoittaa, että Messias on tulossa.
Please prepare.
Valmistautukaa.
But I want to describe something a little bit on this.
Mutta haluan kuvata jotain tästä.
The following fact.
Seuraava fakta.
The fact that the Lord wanted to bring out.
Se, mikä Herra tahtoi tuoda esille.
In that conversation.
Tässä kohtaamisessa.
When I woke up,
kun heräsin,
the first thing I did, I checked my teeth on the mirror.
Ensimmäiseksi katsoin peilistä, onko hampaat kunnossa.
Because I thought I had crushed my teeth.
Koska musta tuntui, että ne meni rikki siellä.
Why?
Miksi?
Because the Lord made me feel.
Koska Herra antoi minun tuntea.
How those who will miss the coming of the Messiah, how they will feel.
Kuinka ne, jotka jäävät pois Messian tulemuksesta, kuinka he tuntevat?
The Bible says the weeping and the gnashing of teeth.
Raamattu sanoo itku ja hammasten kiristys.
But I did not know that he would make his servant feel it and know how he's going to be on that läpi.
Mutta en arvannut, että hän tekee palvelijansa tuntemaan näitä samoja tuntemuksia.
And so when I roll and crush my teeth and gnashing of teeth and weeping and wailing, then I understood the message the Lord wanted to bring to the church.
Ja siinä pyöriessäni maassa ja kiristellessäni hampaitani tunsin sen, mitä Herra tarkoitti tällä.
He wanted to tell the church.
Ja tahtoi sanoa seurakunnalle.
That you heard it said.
Sinä olit uskossa.
You heard it said.
Ja sinä tiesit, että se pelastaa.
That prepare the way.
Mutta valmista.
The Messiah is coming.
Koska Herra on tullut, Messias on tullut.
But I tell you the truth.
Mutta kerron sen todellisuus.
For those who shall not prepare.
Että ne, jotka eivät valmista.
When that day will arrive.
Kun se päivä tulee.
That day will be irreversible.
Tämä päivä tulee olemaan kammottava.
That day will be irretrievable.
Se tulee olemaan hirvittävä.
That day will be irredeemable.
Se tulee olemaan kammottava.
That day will be unstoppable.
Se tulee olemaan pysäyttämätön.
I have gone all over the world.
Minä olen ilmoittanut sen maailman.
Right now, after tomorrow, I will head to Brazil.
Olen menossa Brasiliaan.
Announcing these things the Lord is talking about.
Ilmoitan nämä, mistä Herra puhuu.
But I'm saying this.
Mutta sanon tämän.
That as I build this ark. As I'm building this ark.
Tämän arkin rakentaminen.
I see a lot of complacency.
Nämä paljon mutkaisia asioita.
Sometimes I see nations not bothered.
Joskus näen, että kansakunnat eivät ole valmiita.
And yet the Lord has said.
Ja vaikka Herra on valmiin pelastanut.
Build this ark of righteousness.
Rakenna tämä arkki vanhurskaudelle.
Build this ark of holiness.
Rakenna tämä pyhityksen arkki.
Go to every nation.
Mene jokaiseen maan.
And tell them to come aboard. Come onto the ark to build it with you. Because the day is coming.
Kutsu ihmisiä tulemaan arkkien sisälle, sillä päivä on tuleva.
When the door is shut,
jolloin ovi pannaan kiinni.
And like it was during the time of Noah.
Ja kuten se oli Noan aikana.
So shall it be on that day.
Niin se tulee olemaan niinä päivinä.
The gnashing of teeth.
Että itkuja hammasta kirjoittaa.
The weeping.
Itku.
But too late.
Mutta se on myöhä.
Has already happened.
Kun se jo tapahtuu.
And always remember that he that speaks with you, I have seen the coming of the Messiah.
Muista aina, että etukäteen olen nähnyt Messiaan tulemisen.
Like the many prophecies are given and are fulfilled.
Ja monet profetiat ovat toteutuneet.
Like the many healings you see in these meetings.
Ja monia parantumisia tapahtuu.
The Lord is saying,
Herra sanoo,
so shall the coming of the Messiah which he has announced.
Niin tulee olemaan Messian päivä.
So all these things are meant to build up one testimony that look, the Messiah must come.
Sen tarkoitus on rakentaa tämä yksi todistus, katso, he Messias tulee.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And so this is in the web, you can download it, it's free of charge PDF, you can print it in any version and any language.
Joten tämä on se, mitä voitte tallentaa ja kääntää eri kielillä levittää.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And so this is the hour of truth in the church.
Tämä on totuuden hetki seurakunnalle.
That's why I come.
Siitä syystä olen tullut.
Now, I want to have with you a very profound conversation, very deep today.
Haluan hyvin syvällisen kanssakäymisen kanssa.
Very deep.
Hyvin syvällisen.
About the glory of the Lord.
Herran kirkkaudesta.
This visitation.
Tästä
and what this visitation is saying to the church today.
Mitä tämä vierailu antaa tänään?
Listen, precious people.
Kuuntele, siunattu kansa.
I have been revealed to more and more about this visitation.
Minulle on paljastettu enemmän tästä käynnistä.
And it looks like this is an endless theme. Endless.
Tämä on loputon.
It has no end.
Sillä ei ole loppua.
Yes, indeed, our God has no end.
Sillä Jumalalla ei ole loppua.
And I say it.
Ja sanon sen.
In our own nature. We should have disqualified ourselves from discussing this glory. But owing to the love that the Lord, the disposition of love, the leading of love He has given this generation. Now He has allowed us to discuss these things that we may be revealed to, we may be wise unto salvation. That we may be wise unto the kingdom of God. As you are going to see very briefly, this is just not a simple thing. This essentially, this is just not, it's not a simple thing. It's not a small thing. This amounts to God bowing down the heavens to be able to reach your ignorance about heaven. To be able to reach your narrow understanding capacity on the truth of the salvation of God.
Niin, että tulet ymmärtämään sen kapasiteetin, mikä totuudella ja pelastuksella on Jumala.
If God did not make attempts to bow the glorious heavens to meet us, we would be finished. Yeah. We cannot understand the mysteries of the kingdom.
Meidän on ymmärrettävä taivaan salaisuudet.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
So this is not a small thing.
Tämä on se asia.
That the Lord may come from His upper chambers of wisdom in heaven, and come to speak to us in our tongues. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And so, Moses.
Moses.
Again, I say that every time the Lord speaks, only the Bible is the best reference. So that now when we have the Bible and the Lord speaks in such a profound way, and we relate it, we are able to line it up with Bible, with Scripture, then we get the message. And I also say that that is part of the reason there is a fall in the church in Finland. Because many times you have invited people here who have said, oh, the Lord has said, oh, the Lord has said. And then probably you have failed to line up what they are saying in Scripture. And that has become the gateway for apostasy to enter the church. But the truth has now come. That you may be wise unto salvation. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Because for the truth will set you free. Okay, now I want to share it a bit on again Moses, the man of God.
Moses.
How he interacted with this same glory, this same one. Thank you so much. How he interacted with the same glory? And what message came forth from there? What message came forth from there about the kingdom of God? Now listen to this now. Read with me right away in the book of Exodus 33, verses 15 and 16. 33, Exodus 33.
Toinen Mooseksen kirja 33.
My son Aaron is here.
15.
I'm very blessed to see you people. Hallelujah. And my daughters are here. I am coming, says the Lord. Exodus 33. I am glad I have a family in Finland. That means I can keep coming and coming until you enter.
Hallelujah.
So the book of Exodus, I know we are live on TV, we are live all over the world, even Even on FM radios globally. Exodus chapter 33. I am reading verses 15 and 16. But if you see, if you're the Bible like mine, from verse 12, the subtitle of verse 12 says, Moses and the glory of the Lord.
Jos täällä laittaisi jonkinlaisen aloitsikon, niin se tarkoittaa Mooseksen Jumalan kirkkaus.
So that is the subtitle. We talk about the glory.
Se on aloitsikko.
But now I want to read verse 15 and 16 for the purposes of this message I'm giving today.
Joten haluan lukea nämä jakeet 15 ja 16 tämän päivän sanomaan varten.
I read one verse and then you read one verse in Finnish.
Luen ensin englanniksi ja sitten te suomeksi.
Then Moses said to him, If your presence does not go with us, do not send us up from here.
Moses vastasi hänelle, ellei sinä kulje kanssani, älä vie meitä täältä.
How will anyone know that you are pleased with me and with your people unless you go with us? What else will distinguish me and your people from all the other people? Of the earth.
Mistä muutoin voidaan tietää, että me olemme saaneet armon sinun silmissäsi, minä ja sinun kanssasi, ellei siitä, että sinä kuljet kanssamme ja että meillä, minulla ja sinun kansallasi on erityisasema kaikkien kansojen joukossa maan päällä.
Halleluja.
Halleluja.
You can see right away.
Voit nähdä heti saman.
But the title of this little segment here, this is a small one, the introductory segment, this one here.
Että tämä johdanto otsikko.
I'm using this segment to introduce the message of today.
Käytän sitä esittelemään ja johdattelemaan tämän päivän sanansa.
And you can see clearly.
Ja voit nähdä selvästi.
That the title, if you, those who are writing, the title becomes Distinguishing God's People.
Ihmisten erottaminen.
Distinguishing God's people.
Kansan erottaminen. Jumalan kansan erottaminen.
Very good. Distinguishing God's people. Yeah. That is the title. To distinguish God's people.
Jumalan kansan erottaminen, tämä on se otsikko.
Now listen to this now.
Ja nyt kuunnellaan.
Focus with me for a moment.
Ja kiinnittäkää huomioon.
Here was Israel.
Ja tässä on Israel.
Here was Moses.
Ja tässä on Moses.
And so, in their interaction with the Lord,
Herran kanssa,
in their dealings with God,
se miten he ovat Jumalan kanssa tekemisissä,
the glory of the Lord descended.
Jumalan kirkkaus laskeutui.
That is the love that God apportioned them.
Tämä on se laki, miten Herra toi.
That is the portion of his love he gave to them. He came to them himself.
Se on se hänen osuutensa, että hän tuli alas.
And then,
ja se on hänen rakkautensa heille.
Can you change this? Can you just sit here so you can help to hear? Please sit near here, Anna. Anna, sit here, please. Nice. Thank you very much. So you can make the corrections. Just sit there so that you can help him. By just whispering the right word, or shouting it properly. Okay. So everybody focus on me now. The glory had come down.
Kirkkaus on tullut alas.
And then,
ja sitten,
manna, they had eaten manna from heaven.
Ja he ovat syöneet mannaa taivaasta.
He had spoken to them by voice audibly.
Ja hän puhui sitten tämän jälkeen.
And so this thing of love had happened to them.
Ja tämä on tapahtunut heille.
And then now,
ja sitten,
they were going to the world.
He ovat menossa maailmaan.
And then Moses asked.
Ja Moses kysyi.
But wow,
wow,
we have seen your glory.
Me olemme nähneet sinun kirkkautesi.
You have walked here, you have lived with us in the temple. You have walked among us here.
Sinä olet kulkenut täällä.
We have eaten bread from your throne.
Me olemme syöneet sinun valtakunnallisesi.
We've heard your voice.
Olemme kuulleet sinun äänesi.
But now as we go out there.
Mutta nyt kun menemme ulos.
Into the world.
Maailmaan.
If your presence does not go with us.
Jos kirkkautesi ei kulje meidän kanssamme.
Please.
Olkaa.
Don't send us. Don't.
Älä lähetä meitä.
Please don't. We are not ready to deal with those people.
Me emme ole valmiita kohtaamaan noita ihmisiä.
We know those people.
Me tiedämme ne kanssa.
They are very stubborn.
Ne ovat hyvin jääräpäisiä.
They will not believe.
Ne eivät usko.
In other words.
Ja toisin sanoen.
Shall we go out there?
Mennäänkö me sinne?
And then we also be the same as them.
Ja meidät lähetetään sinne. Ja mekin olemme kuin he.
In other words.
Ja toisilla sanoo.
You have come down in your glory.
Ja sinä olet tullut kirkkaudessasi alas.
With power.
Voima.
By force.
Voima.
By manna we have eaten from your hands.
Ja olemme syöneet sinun kädestäsi. Manna.
After all this mighty visitation of the Godhead, the God the Father.
Ja kaikki tämä valtava Jumalan vierailu.
Shall we then just go there and be like the other people also?
Ja sinne kun me vaan mennään, ollaksemme samanlaisia kuin he.
Do you understand the question that Moses was confronting?
Huomaatko mitä Moses kysyi?
To Moses.
Moses.
He already knew.
And jo tiesi.
That there is no way.
Että ei ole mitään mahdollisuutta.
There is no way whatsoever.
Että koskaan.
That you can experience such mighty visitation of historic levels.
Että voi kokea tämän mahtavan kokemuksen.
And then you just go and be normal.
Ja sitten jatkat ihan normaalina.
Be like the civilian out there.
Ihan niin kuin ne muut kansat siellä.
Did you understand this? I'm not yet moving, but I'm just starting. But I want you to understand the question that Moses, the question he was confronted with.
Haluan juuri tätä, että mitenkä Moses vastusti tässä.
He was saying.
Hän sanoi.
Moses was saying.
Moses sanoi.
I think this is historic. Historic.
Tämä on historia.
Moses was saying, I think this is not usual.
Yeah, Moses sanoi, tämä ei ole tavallista.
This is not normal.
Tämä ei ole normaal.
Moses was saying,
Moses sanoi,
that there is no way we are going to be the same again.
Ei ole mahdollista, että olemme enää samanlaisia.
And that's why Moses asked.
Ja siksi Moses kysyi.
Now that your glory has come.
Nyt sinun kirkkautesi on tullut.
And now that we have eaten from heaven.
Ja me olemme syöneet taivaasta.
And now that even the coming of your glory is the love you have shown us.
Ja se kirkkaus, joka on tullut alas ja näyttänyt rakkautensa meille.
Tell me one thing. Tell me one thing.
Kerro minulle eräs asia.
Thank you. To reduce the volume a bit. Okay, can you lower just a notch? Don't lower too much, but just a little bit. Thank you, my son.
What was that? Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much. Just lower a little bit. Let me see first how much you lower.
Yeah.
Let me estimate the lowering so that I'm not, that they don't infringe on my rights. Hallelujah, that's okay. That's okay. I don't want, because tomorrow I'm a healing son. That's okay now. Thank you very much. Thank you. I can remember my son there. You drove me the other day to your vascular and everywhere, Tampere. Thank you so much. But now listen to this. I think that's okay now?
Yeah, I think I'm okay.
Okay, now listen to this.
Yeah, go on.
He's saying
that
Moses was facing this type of question.
Yeah, Moses, kohtaa tämän kysymyksen.
In his heart of hearts.
Hänen sydämessä.
In the inside of his heart of hearts of hearts. He knew that this was unusual. But he did not know how to go about it. So the question then began. Now that they were going to the world. Moses asked. How will the other people on the face of the earth look at us and see that we are distinguished from them?
Miten muut kansakunnat näkevät meidät ja kuinka me olemme heistä erillään?
Because Moses knew that the visitation of the cloud of God had come to distinguish his people. And so, when Moses asked this question, how will those people out there know that you are pleased with us? That you are pleased with me and with your people. Please with us. And what is it that will distinguish us from them? And that is the message that the church is caught up in today. Because many people have become Christians and died. And they did not see this visitation. But now you that have partaken of this visitation, you must be confronted with this question. We that have been visited by the Godhead himself, what is it that when we go out there, will distinguish us from the other people? Can I answer this question now? Because this is the generation that is visited. This is the charge that has been visited. The charge of this hour. Because I know you are saying, oh Kenya, how beautiful you are. God is loving you. I see God is visiting you. I see God is visiting you. How blessed you are. Kenya, don't misuse it. I heard many things about this. But I want you to know that this visitation is bigger than one country. This is the visitation of the Lord inside the house of the Lord. Because I gave the prophecy November 21st. November 21st, the prophecy. And then come December 31st, it was fulfilled even the 2 by picture. And so, essentially, this is a healing service. This is a major revival service. So, that is a visitation inside the house of the Lord. In Kenya, in Finland, in everywhere. Hallelujah. And that's why we are all confronted with this question. What has he come to do? And so Moses asked the question I'm going to address now. What is it that will distinguish us from the rest of the world now that you have visited us? Hallelujah. Now listen to this. If you read the book of Exodus, chapter 3. I am now answering the question. What is it that will distinguish us from the rest of the people? We that you have loved and visited. You have loved us so much that you have come yourself to visit us. But what is it now that will distinguish us and the other people? That is important. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Exodus 3 verses 4 to 6, right? I'm reading verse 4 of Exodus chapter 3. Verse 4, I am reading Exodus chapter 3. He says, when the Lord saw that he had gone over to look, God called to him from within the bush
tässä olen.
Here I am.
Tässä olen.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Can I give you the picture here?
Voisi vaikka tämän kuvan.
The same God the Father.
Sama Isä Jumala.
Comes as a consuming fire.
Tulee kuluttavana tulee.
The bush is not burning up.
Siis ei kuluttavana tulena, peltas ei pala.
But he saw fire.
Mutta hän näkee tulen.
And Moses was stepped out to check.
Ja Moses astuu katsomaan.
And he says, when he saw that he had gone there to look.
Ja kun hän sanoi, niin katso.
Then God called out.
Se kutsui ulos.
Moses. Here I am.
Täällä minä olen.
Now look what's happened. Verse 5. Do not come any closer, God said. Take off your sandals, for the place where you are standing is holy ground.
Jumala sanoi, älä tule lähemmäksi, riisu kengät jalastasi, sillä paikka, jossa seisot, on pyhää maata.
Do not come any closer now.
Älä tule yhtään lähemmäksi.
Take off those sandals.
Ota sandaalit pois jalasta.
For the place where you now stand.
Koska paikka, jossa seisot juuri nyt.
Has now become holy ground.
On tullut pyhäksi maaksi.
That's very powerful. And then listen to this now, verse 6.
Katsotaan myöskin kuudetta jälkeen.
Then Moses said. Then he said, I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob. And at this Moses hid his face, was afraid to look at God. He fell, he closed his face, he didn't want to see this now.
Hän sanoi vielä, minä olen sinun isäsi Jumala, Abrahamin Jumala, Iisakin Jumala ja Jaakobin Jumala. Silloin Mooses peitti kasvonsa, sillä hän pelkäsi katsoa Jumalaa.
So you see,
joten näet,
when Moses now meets God the Father,
kun Mooses nyt kohtaa Isä Jumala,
in his glory,
hänen kirkkaudessa,
then there is a formal introduction, official introduction.
Niin siinä on tällainen virallinen esittely.
I am the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, the God of Jacob.
Minä olen Abraham, Isaakin ja Jaakobin Jumala.
Then Moses realized that this is the Mega, the grand Mega visitation.
Joten Moses ymmärtää, että tämä on nyt se Mega vierailu.
And you see the events that transpire from that point on.
Ja huomaat, mihin se sitten tuollaisen muutoksen se aikaa.
These are the events that happen after that.
Ne on asioita, jotka tapahtuu tässä.
Before I answer the question, how will they distinguish us?
Ennen kuin palaan siihen asiaan, niin ehkä tämä.
The events that transpire. The events that happen.
Tämä tapahtumat, jotka tapahtuu.
First of all.
Ensinnäkin.
You see the changing of the identity of Moses.
Moseksen identiteetin muuttuminen.
When you meet this glory of God the Father.
Tapaa tämän Jumalan kirkkauden, Isä Jumalan kirkkauden.
It doesn't matter whether you're Moses.
Ei väliä, oletko Moses.
Or whether you are Kenya.
Olet Elia.
Or you are in Kenya.
Kenya.
In Israel.
Kenialainen.
Or you are Israel.
Israelite.
It doesn't matter whether you are Finland, Helsinki.
Tai olet suomalainen.
Austria, Vienna. Copenhagen.
Tai
Oslo, Norway.
Oslosta, Norway.
Rwanda, Burundi.
Tai Burundista, Norway.
It doesn't matter whether you are South Africa. You're Brazil.
Tai Etelä-Afrikasta, tai
whether you are Tampere,
tai Tampere,
Turku,
Turusta,
Jyväskylä, it doesn't matter,
se ei ole väliä.
But what matters is this,
mutta millä on väliä?
Whoever encounters the glory of God the Father,
että kuka hyvänsä kohtaa Jumalan kirkkauden,
the first thing that happens,
ensimmäinen asia mikä tapahtuu,
there is change of identity. The impact is so enormous, it transforms you. That's why Moses moved from being a shepherd of the sheep of Jethro.
Jethro Lamb of Finland.
He moved from being a shepherd of the sheep of Jethro. Are you from Prague, right? From here, yes, thank you so much. From being a shepherd of the sheep of Jethro. To be now the shepherd of Israel, the sheep of God.
Israel by the next day.
That talks about the following. That talks about you may have been horizontally focused. You are focused on the sheep of Jethro, the sheep of this world. As he was taking care of the sheep of Jethro. And Jethro Lamb essentially talks about the horizontal gospel, the horizontal living. The gospel that is horizontal. The ministry that's horizontal. Hallelujah. The horizontal life.
Yeah, horizontal
earthly, focused on earthly wealth, earthly things, my house in Helsinki, my holiday home in Norway, my job in Finland, my job in Estonia. You see, a very beautiful country, by the way, very beautiful country. Estonia. So focus on this horizontal way. But when he encounters the massive glory of the Godhead, God the Father, you see the tremendous transformation. And you see him now focusing on another type of sheep. Another type of gospel. Another type of ministry. Emphatical connection. Emphatical ministry. Heavenly ministry. Heavenly focus. Heavenly director. Heavenly oriented. Heavenly led. Heavenly going.
Hallelujah.
So if you asked me, he says, whoever encounters the massive power, the massive glory of God the Father, must always be transformed. And if you look at them, and when you look at them, when they used to focus like this, now you see they are focused like this. Let me say, and when the people of the world will see that you are now no longer focused on the earth, that your life and ministry is now vertically connected, that your focus is now heavenly. He says, when they will see that change in you, they don't know that those people have been visited. That is the answer. I like power. Are you going to allow me? Because it's on me. It's really not on you. Thank you. Oh, I have gotten it right. This volume was very good for me. Because I love so much. But is this okay now?
Okay.
A little. Okay, then I will lower my voice. Oh, because my bones are on fire. The nations are in my focus. So I'm burning up. Thank you so much. Thank you. So did you understand what Moses is saying? What the Lord is saying to Moses? The Lord is saying that if you want them to know that you have been visited, then they must see that there is a significant an irreversible change in your life.
Että on huomattava syvällinen muutos sinun elämässä.
He said,
ja hän sanoi,
that you must be heavenly focused.
Sinun täytyy olla taivaaseen suuntautunut.
If they hear your phone.